A system possesses energy if it has the ability to do work. Work shifts energy from one system to another. Energy is a central concept in science. It is abstract and cannot always be perceived. It is given meaning through calculation. Energy can exist in many different forms. All forms of energy are either kinetic or potential. The energy associated with motion is called kinetic energy. The energy associated with position is called potential energy. Energy can be stored in motion just as well as it can be stored in position. Just like work, energy is also expressed in joule. If kinetic energy is the energy of motion, then naturally, kinetic energy of an object at rest should be zero. An object that has motion, whether it is vertical or horizontal, has kinetic energy. There are many forms of kinetic energy. Vibrational, that is the energy due to vibrational motion. Rotational, the energy due to rotations. And translational, the energy due to motion from one location to another. To keep matters simple, we will focus upon translational kinetic energy. The amount of kinetic energy an object has depends upon two variables. The mass of the object, that is m, and the speed of the object, that is v. We will see that there are several different ways of converting work. Let us start with the example of a force applied over a distance to accelerate. With constant total force F, mass m, a car moves from its initial position at x0 to x, with initial velocity u and final velocity v in the x direction. This results in displacement s. Its acceleration a is equal to f over m. Constant force gives constant acceleration. So we can use the third equation of motion to relate the displacement s to the initial and final velocities. The total force is constant and parallel to the displacement, so the work is F times S. Substituting for Newton's second law, we have work equals ma times S. But remembering equation 3, let us multiply by 1 and write the 1 as half times 2. Now we can substitute for 2a times S with just v squared minus u squared. So now we have total work done equals a half mv square minus a half mu squared. This is the change in the quantity half mv squared. That is such an important result that we give the quantity a name. We call that quantity the kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is defined as 1/2 mv squared. What we have proved is that the total work done by all the forces acting on an object is equal to the change in its kinetic energy. Let us check the units. Mv squared is kilograms times meters per second squared. Take one of the meters outside and use the Newton's second law to remind us that kilogram meters per second squared is the unit of force, Newton. And Newtons times meters equals joules. This equation reveals that the kinetic energy of an object is directly proportional to the square of its speed. That means that for a twofold increase in speed, the kinetic energy will increase by a factor of 4. For a threefold increase in speed, the kinetic energy will increase by a factor of 9. To summarize, kinetic energy is a scalar quantity. It does not have a direction. Unlike velocity, acceleration, force, and momentum, the kinetic energy of an object is described completely by magnitude alone. Like work and potential energy, the standard metric of measurement for kinetic energy is the joule.